हेलो गाइस, आई होप यू ऑल आर डूइंग गुड. आई एम विशाली किकान एंड वी आर डिस्कसिंग द VLSI टेक्नोलॉजी. इन दैट वी आर डिस्कसिंग द केमिकल मैकेनिकल पॉलिशिंग और द CMP, एंड दिस इज द थर्ड वीडियो ऑन द CMP. एंड इन द फर्स्ट टू वीडियोज वी हैव ऑलरेडी डिस्कस्ड अबाउट द बेसिक्स एंड द एडवांटेजेस, नेसेसिटीज एंड द एप्लीकेशंस ऑफ द केमिकल मैकेनिकल पॉलिशिंग. आई होप यू ऑल हैव वॉच दीज टू वीडियोज. इफ नॉट, यू कैन वॉच द प्रीवियस टू वीडियोज फर्स्ट and then come to this video. So today in this video we are going to talk about the chemical mechanical polishing hardware or the CMP hardware. So without wasting any time, let's begin with the CMP hardware. So the CMP hardware is basically consisted of the three components. First is the polishing pad, second is the wafer carrier, and third is the slurry dispenser. So these three structures make the CMP hardware. So this is how our CMP hardware would be looking like. Here we have the plate and over which we have the polishing pad. This is a very important structure, okay? And then we have the wafer carrier. This is the full structure, that is the wafer carrier, okay? Here we have the retaining ring and here we have the membrane. Below the membrane we have the wafer, okay? And we are sending the downward pressure towards the wafer holder, and again we are rotating the wafer holder. So wafer holder is rotating also, plus we are sending the downward pressure on the wafer holder as well. Now this is our slurry dispenser, which is sending slurry to the system. Slurry is a very important component for this CMP process to happen. Okay, how, what is slurry? We are going to talk about slurry in detail in the next video. So now this is our linear polishing system. The linear polishing system, our polishing pad is moving in the linear direction, whereas wafer carrier is moving in the rotating direction, circular direction. Rotation are present in the wafer carrier, linear direction motion is present in the polishing pad. So this is our belt and polishing pad, which is moving in the linear direction with the help of these rotating structures, right? This is the second rotating structure that we have. So this is the retaining ring. Here also we have the retaining ring. Okay, this is the green membrane over which we have the wafer. Here we have the support fluid bearing, and we are sending the downward pressure and we are rotating it. Here we have the slurry dispenser, which is sending the slurry to the system, and here we have the pad conditioner. So I hope you understood this structure really well. So now coming to the orbital polishing. In the orbital polishing, we have the orbital motion or the circular motion to the polishing pad as well, right? So here you can see this is our polishing pad, and we are giving the circular motion or the orbital motion to the polishing pad. And this is the slurry, which is moving in the upward direction towards the wafer. This is the wafer, and this is the wafer carrier, okay? So, or the wafer holder. So this is the wafer. Here we have this membrane, and we are sending the downward pressure to this wafer carrier, okay? And again we are rotating it in the circular direction. So this is my orbital polishing system. So now I hope you understood how the linear polishing system is different from the orbital polishing system. The one difference that is present is the movement of the polishing pad. In the orbital polishing system, the polishing pad is moving in the circular direction, whereas in the linear polishing system, our polishing pad is moving in the linear direction, whereas the wafer carrier is moving in both of the cases in the circular direction only. So now coming to the polishing pad. What is polishing pad? The polishing pad is a very important structure, as I have already told you. It is transferring the slurry from the base to the wafer. Okay, so from this polishing pad, the slurry is moving. So it must be a porous structure. Plus it should be flexible polymer material. So it can be casted with the help of sliced polyurethane or urethane coated polyester felt. So pad directly affects the quality of the CMP processes. So if I have two pads, okay, these are two my different kind of polishing pads. So the CMP process done by this pad and this pad would be significantly different, right? So these two CMP processes would be different because the pad quality is different. The pad material would be having three qualities. First, it should be durable. Second, it should be reproducible. Third, it should be compressible at the process temperature. So the process requirement is that it should require high topography selectivity to achieve the surface planarization. Okay, so it should be selective to the particular roughness to give the particular surface planarization. Coming to the hardness of the polishing pad is going to affect the polishing or the planarization output, right? So the planarization or the polished output is different for the different hardness of the polishing pad. So this is my first polishing pad and this is my second polishing pad. Both of them are having different hardness. So the output would be different. How it would be different, we are going to see. So if I have the harder polishing pad, we are going to get better within the die uniformity, right? So if I have a harder pad in a particular die, I am going to get a better uniformity. So here I will be getting high removal rate as well, right? If I have a softer pad, I will be getting better wafer to wafer uniformity. So the two wafer will be having better uniformity if I have the softer pads. But the advantage we have already seen. Now coming to the disadvantage. So the disadvantage is that the harder pads are easier to cause scratches. So whenever I am using the harder pad, it is giving me a better removal rate, but it is going to give me scratches as well. The hardness is controlled by the pad chemical composition or by the cellular structure. So this is how the composition or cellular structure of the polishing pad is very important and it should be highly controlled. So the cells absorb the polishing slurry, right? So now after that we have the fillers that is going to improve the mechanical properties of the polishing pad. Both of these structures are, or both of these things are very important in the polishing pad. So polishing pad surface roughness determines the conformality range as well. I hope you remember what was conformality. So smoother pad has poor topographic selectivity, less planarization effect would be there if I have the smoother pad. If I have the rougher pad, which means I will be having better planarization polishing results, but it has no longer conformality range. Conformality range would be removed. So this is how our harder rough pad would be looking like. This is my wafer. This is my wafer, this is the film which is having the roughness. This is the first roughness, this is the second roughness. So this is my polishing pad which is hard and this is how the pad is moving in this direction. So it is going to give me better planarization structure. So this is my soft smoothing pad would be looking like. Again here this is my wafer, this is the film which is having the roughness over here and the roughness over here, and the pad is moving again in this direction. So you can see here we will be getting lesser planarization in compared to the hard smoothing pad, right? So now coming to the pad conditioning. What is pad conditioning? What happens if I'm using pad again and again for the different types of wafers? So it is going to get smoother due to the polishing effect. So now we need to recreate the rough pad surface from the smoothened out pad. We have to again get it back into the rough condition. So in situ pad conditioners are used to get back the pad into its rough conditions. So the conditioner resurfaces the pad. It is going to remove the used slurry from the pad and it is going to supply the fresh slurry towards the surface of the pad. So this is a very important thing that is required in this process. So polishing pad and the pad conditioner is looking like this. So here we have the wafer carrier. This is my polishing pad and this is my pad conditioner. So here we have the slurry dispenser. Right, so now coming to the polishing head. Polishing head is also called the wafer carrier. I have already shown you how the wafer carrier was looking like. It consists of a polishing head body. Then it consists of retaining ring. I already shown you the structure. Again, I am going to show you the picture. It consists of a carrier membrane and a down force driving system as well. So you can see here we have the retaining ring. This is the retaining ring that we have, the outer structure. Inside that we have the carrier membrane and here we have the polishing head body. Overall this structure is called the polishing head. Okay, so this is the schematic of the polishing head. You can see here we have the wafer, over that we have the membrane. This is the retaining ring. Okay, here we have the retaining ring positioning structure. Okay, here we have the vacuum chunk which is holding the wafer. Right, we are holding the wafer with the help of vacuum pressure. Okay, and then we have the downward pressure दिस इज द डाउनवर्ड प्रेशर एंड दिस इज द कैरियर चैम्बर. सो नाउ कमिंग टू द पैड कंडीशनर. आई हैव ऑलरेडी टोल्ड यू पैड कंडीशनर इज अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट कॉम्पोनेंट इन द हार्डवेयर of this system. So now it pad conditioner sweeps across the pad to increase the surface roughness required by the planarization, and again it removes the used slurry. So these are two important things that the pad conditioner is doing. First, it is increasing the surface roughness. Second, it is removing the used slurry. And third, it is giving it the next unused slurry or the new slurry to the structure. So conditioner is a stainless steel plate coated with the nickel plate diamond grits. Then again we have a next structure of the conditioner would be called the die bond CMP conditioner. First is simple, a stainless steel plate over which I have nickel plated diamond grits. Second is the die bond CMP conditioner in which we have the stainless steel plate coated with the CVD diamond film plated with the diamond grids. So you can see here we have the conventional conditioner. This is the conventional conditioner in which we have stainless steel plate over which we have the diamond grids over which we have the nickel film, right? And here this is the die bond conditioner in which I have the stainless steel over which we have the silicon substrate over which we have diamond grids of nearly 20 micrometer size and over which we have the diamond film. So here you can see this is how the conventional and the die bond conditioners will be different. So these are the references. I hope you understood each one of the thing that we have discussed in this video very well. If you want to talk about these things in a great detail, you can refer these books. These are amazing books. And further, if you have any doubt, you can put the doubt in the comment and I will be trying to resolve your doubt as soon as possible. I hope you like this session. If you like it, please push the like button, subscribe to the channel, and also do share it with your friends. Thank you so much.